Unit 12, Markets, Efficiency, and Public Policy. We looked at the behavior of buyers and sellers under different market conditions and conditions under which the competitive equilibrium is Pareto efficient. In reality, markets may allocate resources in a Pareto inefficient way, which we refer to as market failure. What are the sources of these inefficiencies? How can government solve the problem? Examples of market failure. 1. Pesticides in the Caribbean. Banana plantation owners used harmful pesticides to reduce costs and increase their profits. The chemicals leaked into the rivers and contaminated the local seafood, causing residents to fall seriously ill. 2. Overuse of antibiotics. People often use antibiotics when other treatments would be better, which creates bacteria-resistant pathogens. Why do markets fail? The conditions for markets to work well are private property. The rights to the things bought/sold must be clear. Institutions, example, government must enforce those property rights. The social norms must respect property rights. And ability to write complete and enforceable contracts that can be evaluated in a court of law. Markets fail when property rights are missing, incomplete, or are difficult to enforce with a contract. In this chapter, we discuss causes of market failures, external effects, asymmetric information, and incomplete contracts. Possible solutions, private bargaining, government policies. The limits of markets. Should all goods be allocated via markets? Key concepts. External effects. External effect, externality, equal, an effect of an economic decision that is not specified as a benefit or liability in the contract. It can be a cost or benefit that falls on people external to the trade. Here we look at the effect of a negative externality when the cost of an action is not accounted for in the private costs of the producer when deciding upon the quantity to produce. The banana producer does not take the full cost of its action into account. So it is useful to think of the difference between the marginal private cost and the marginal external cost. The banana producer looks at its marginal private cost, MPC curve, when deciding how much to produce. If there were no external costs, the marginal external cost, MEC, would be zero. But here we know there are external costs which rise with each extra ton of bananas that are produced, because more and more pesticide is used, which kills more fish and causes more losses to the fishermen. Marginal external cost curve is upward sloping. Marginal social cost, MSC curve, reflects the sum of MPC plus MEC, which is the full cost to society. Result. Pareto inefficiency. Graph shows plantations produce where price equals MPC at point A, 80,000 tons. Pareto efficient level is where price equals MSC, 38,000 tons. Negative external effect leads to overproduction and overuse of pesticide. Outcome is not Pareto efficient. Both parties can be made better off by cutting back on production to the point where P equals MSC. At point A, fishermen could pay plantation owners up to $270 to reduce production by one unit. The loss to the fishermen is $270 if the last ton is produced. They could offer to pay that to the plantation owner to cut back production. In this case, they would be no worse off but the plantation owner would be better off since they are getting $270 while losing only a minimal amount in terms of the marginal profit. This negotiation can go on till output is cut back to 38,000 tons. We would get the socially optimal outcome at that point. Solution number one, bargaining. Legally assign property rights to the externality. Example, the right to pollute or the right to clean water. Private bargaining between parties involved will result in a Pareto efficient allocation regardless of which party has the property rights in the absence of transaction costs. May be more effective than government intervention because private parties have more of the necessary information. However, transaction costs, costs of acquiring information, enforcing the contract, or collective action can be a major obstacle in reality. Bargaining. Example. In the pesticides example, there is a net social gain that parties could share by reducing production because the fall in plantation's profit is smaller than the gain for the fishermen. Loss of profits is shown by the purple area on the graph. Total gain to the fishermen is the sum of the green and purple area. So net social gain is shown by the green area. Plantation owners' minimum acceptable offer, minimum compensation equal lost profits. Fisherman's reservation option, maximum compensation equals sum of purple and green areas. Actual compensation depends on relative bargaining power. Practical limits of bargaining. Impediments to collective action. Finding a representative and agreeing on how to split the gains within each party. Missing information. Calculating the exact costs imposed on each fisherman and each plantation's contribution to pollution. Enforcement. It may be difficult for a court to determine whether plantations have complied or not. Limited funds. Fishermen may not have enough money to pay plantations the compensation required. Solution number two, government policies. 1. Regulation of production. Cap at socially optimal amount. May be difficult to determine and enforce the right quota for each polluter. 2. Pigouvian tax/subsidy. Tax/subsidy on firms generating negative/positive external effects in order to correct an inefficient market outcome. 3. Enforcing compensation for affected parties. Example, pollution tax. Government puts a per unit tax on output equal to the MEC. Profit maximizing producer will choose output where MPC equals after tax price, which is the socially optimal output. The tax forces producers to face the full cost of their decisions. Example, compensation. Government requires plantation owners to pay fishermen compensation for each ton produced. Required compensation is equal to the difference between the MSC and the MPC, gray area. Fishermen are fully compensated and producers choose the socially optimal level of output of 38,000 tons. Similar effect on profits compared to a tax, but fishermen are better off, receive payment instead of the government. Practical limits of policies. Similar limitations to those for private bargaining. Missing information. Government may not know the exact compensation needed to correct the problem. Measurement. Marginal social costs are difficult to measure. lobbying, the government may favor the more powerful group, in which case it could impose a Pareto efficient outcome that is unfair. Why do external costs slash benefits occur? External costs cause market failure due to incomplete contracts. Incomplete contracts do not specify in an enforceable way every aspect of the exchange that affects the interests of all affected parties, seen already in Unit 6. Contracts that include external costs slash benefits are not enforceable because the relevant information is not verifiable or asymmetric, not known by decision maker. Therefore, in reality, it is impossible to use contracts or property rights so that all social costs slash benefits are included in the decision-making process. Market failure. Other types. 1. Public goods. Classification criteria. Nature of good. Public good equal non-rival. May or may not be excludable. Non-rival characteristic is important in defining public goods. Non-rival means used by one person does not reduce its availability to others. Non-excludable means impossible to exclude anyone from having access. Figure shows that private goods are rivalrous in consumption. One person's use reduces its availability to others, and excludable can exclude people who do not pay for the good from its use, such as food, clothes, and houses. Common pooled resources, fish stock in a lake, common grazing land are rivalrous in consumption but non-excludable. Public goods are non-rivalrous in consumption but could be excludable or non-excludable. Uncongested toll roads are non-rivalrous in consumption but excludable because those who do not pay the toll can be excluded from using them. View of a lunar eclipse, public broadcasts, rules of arithmetic or calculus, natural defense, noise and air pollution are examples of public goods that are non-rivalrous in consumption and non-excludable. Public goods and market failure. Markets typically allocate private goods, but for the other three types, markets are not possible or likely to fail. Non-rival goods have a marginal cost of zero, so it is not possible to set price equals MC unless provision is subsidized. It is impossible to set a price for non-excludable goods because the provider cannot exclude those who haven't paid. Example, if one farmer invests in a community irrigation project, other farmers receive external benefits, but it is difficult to make them pay for the benefits or write contracts that guarantee a Pareto efficient irrigation level. Remember Unit 4. Market failure. Other types. 2. Asymmetric information. When information is asymmetric, one party knows something relevant to the transaction, but the other party does not. Two forms of asymmetric information. 1. Hidden action leads to a moral hazard problem. Example, involuntary unemployment because employers cannot observe employees' exact work effort. Unit 6. 2. Hidden attributes leads to an adverse selection problem. Example, buyers of second-hand cars do not know all the attributes of the car. Example, quality, but the sellers do. Example number 1. Health insurance. Health insurance is voluntary. Take the viewpoint of the insurance company, which cannot observe the health of the people buying insurance. Purchasers know their health status. The less healthy are more likely to buy. To be profitable, the company must charge prices high enough and only the less healthy people are willing to buy. This adverse selection means that most people buying insurance already know they have a health problem. There is a missing market. Many healthier people who would like to buy insurance will remain uninsured. Example number 2, car insurance. Any form of insurance also has a hidden action problem. The buyer may take more risks now that he/she is insured. Example, purchasing full coverage against damage may make someone more careless in driving. Insurance companies can put some limits in a contract but cannot enforce other types of behavior. Example, driving speed. This moral hazard problem is another principal agent problem, and we can also think of it in terms of external effects. Being careful gives external benefits to the company. Example number 3, the banking system. Borrowing and lending is another principal agent problem in which the borrower's decisions have external effects on the lender. For this reason, poor borrowers are often credit constrained or credit excluded, which is a form of credit market failure. Another form of credit market failure is the banks themselves. If they take risks and go bankrupt, other banks whom they have borrowed from will bear some of the costs. Governments will also bail out banks that are too big to fail, which incentivizes risk-taking behavior. Market failure, other types. 3. Price greater than marginal cost. Firms may set price above marginal cost because of limited competition. Example, selling differentiated product, Unit 7. Decreasing long-run average costs due to economies of scale. Example, natural monopoly, Unit 7. Leads to market failure because allocation is not Pareto efficient. Competition policy through antitrust laws could break up a monopolies or prevent the formation of monopolies. In this case, the competitive equilibrium would be attained. Limits to markets. Should markets allocate everything? Arguments against using markets for everything. Repugnant markets. Creating a market for certain goods, services would violate ethical, social norms. Example, slavery. Other institutions may be more effective. Example, governments, families. Market mechanisms may crowd out norms of social preferences. Merit goods. Goods that should be available to everyone independently of their ability to pay. Example, education. Watch the video, Michael Sandel investigating the moral limits of his audience in his TED talk, Why We Shouldn't Trust Markets with Our Civic Life, in the textbook, or copy and paste this link in a new window. Summary. 1. Sources of market failure. External costs or benefits. Asymmetric information. Hidden action. Hidden attributes. Limited competition. P greater than MC. 2. Possible solutions. Regulation, taxation, compensation. 3. Markets for other types of goods. Public goods and public bads. Limits to markets. Not every good should have a market.